Hey, 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 family, welcome back, welcome back. For the new folks, hi, I'm Dr. D. I am the owner of Come Alive Coaching and Transformative Services, and then the Lord has blessed me with this ministry, Psych and Spirit. And so if you're new here and you want to stay connected, please feel free to hit all the bells and buttons, all the stuff, like, share, subscribe, hit the bell, all that stuff. Otherwise, just pop back when you want to. Okay, so I'm going to jump in today. Today is a little bit different. So this message is a little bit different. So this is just kind of a quick reminder, and encouragement word. And so, all of you all know when you kind of sit with God and when you try and make it a practice to talk with Him and to see Him in everything, He will reveal Himself in literally everything. And so I had a really cool experience. The other day I was sitting at my, desk and I was looking at one of the plants. On my desk. And so my desk in my office, there's no windows. It's a really small little pot. It's, you know, nothing fancy, nothing special. But the ivy that I have in that pot is just going wild. That is a happy plant. It is growing up a storm. I have another ivy. I have like probably 10 or 11 house plants, probably more actually. But I have another ivy, same type of ivy and everything. And it's in a much bigger pot. It's here at my house. And so it's right in front of a window. I have a big picture window in my living room. It's in front of a window. It's got a big pot. It's on a pretty stand. It's got all my different little knickknacks and all that kind of stuff. Y'all can see all the knickknacks behind me, but all of that. And so that ivy though, it has barely grown. And I've had that ivy for probably at this point, at least a year. The one on my desk, I've had maybe 6 months, probably slightly less. And so as I was kind of looking at my ivies, I started fussing over the one at home and I was like, well, this, it's alive, but like, it's not growing. It's, you know, it's actually starting to be a little yellow as opposed to green. Like, what's going on? And so the Lord gave me a really cool, kind of word behind those two different ivies. And so what He said was, alive doesn't necessarily mean growing. And so I kind of sat with that and I was like, well, Lord, what? And so basically what He revealed to me through the very kind of physical, tangible evidence of these two plants was that that plant at my office, it was in a smaller pot. It had no windows. It doesn't get my little fertilizers that I do at home. Like, I fertilize my plants at home. It doesn't have a little fertilizer. It doesn't have all the knickknacks and the fanciness and all that. And that plant is just like the bomb. Versus the one at home that had all, seemingly all the physical things that a plant could ever need. It gets fertilized, it gets watered, it's in front of a grand window, all these different things, got a big pretty pot. Nothing, right? And so what He revealed to me and He showed me was the difference in these two plants was one thing, and that was the light source. So in my office, I have a like kind of a light under my desk and it's like a long bar. And so I flip it on at the start of the day and it's on all day long. And so that plant gets about 40 hours of light, like direct light. The plant at my house, I've been doing a bit of teleworking, and so I've noticed that even though I have a big picture window and I open the curtains, the way that the sun hits my house, it's that plant is kind of always in a shadow, and I never noticed that. I never caught that because I kind of crack the windows open, and then the curtains open, and I head out to work, so I was never there to see how the light was coming in through the windows. It sits in a shadow most of the day. So what God kind of revealed to me was when we're looking at our own lives and we feel like, God, things feel stagnant, like I'm alive, but I'm languishing, right? Like I'm not happy, not necessarily depressed. I'm just kind of like in this void in the middle. I'm languishing. God revealed to me that the cure for that or the way to move from simply being alive to actually flourishing and growing is to bask in His presence, right? The amount of time that we spend, we spend connecting to the source. The source is our Father, right? This literally with the plant, it's literally the sun. That is our source. Like with the plants, it's S-U-N. With us, it's S-O-N, right? So being able to sit with God, to sit with the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and to bask in the light that is them, that is actually where we're going to start to see our lives flourish and change, where we're going to move from stagnant to really flourishing, to growing. And just like I said, the circumstances did not change. Not a one, right? That pot is still small. It's still in a corner. There's still no windows. It's still not getting fertilized. And it is just blossoming. What I actually did for the plant at home was I got a little lamp thing. And I've started to shine that on the plants. I have a whole plant stand when I leave. And I've been doing that for about 2 weeks. And already the leaves that were once green, were once yellowing, are now turning green. The plant that I was like, it's not growing at all, has like shot up by like this much. It's already starting to kind of grow. Some of the other plants that were like a little wilted down, you can see them turning to the light source. So the I have a different type of ivy as well. And it's starting to kind of snake around and turn to the light. And so nothing physically changed with these plants at home, except they spent more time basking in the sun, right? The direct source of what they need. And God wants us to remember to do the same thing. Don't get so caught up in the physical things that we can see. Well, God, my pot's kind of small. Well, God, you know, I don't have a window. Well, God, I don't get fertilized. We don't need any of that, right? We don't need the education man says we need. We don't need the money man says we need. We don't need the jobs or the houses or the cars or the clothes. We don't need any of the conditions that man says we need. All we have to do is get connected to the source, which is our God. All we have to do is bask in his presence. If nothing else changes, if you don't get another dollar, if you don't get a newer house, if you don't get another car, if nothing else changes, if you do that, if you get to the point where you can sit in the secret place with God, where you can press into him, you will start to see growth, and you will start to see those things that felt stagnant start to bloom and blossom. But the only way to do that is to make sure that we stay in his presence and we stay connected to him. And for me, everybody who watches this channel knows, because I've said it 1,000 times, I am analytical, I am type A. And so for me, it's like, okay, I hear that and it sounds beautiful, but how do I actually do that? What does that mean? Press in. What does it mean? Get in the secret place. What does it mean? Bask in the source. What that means is being intentional about the time that you spend with God. It doesn't have to be ritualized. It doesn't have to be a fancy ceremony, none of those things. But making it a point to say, God, I know that you exist. I know that you're with me, right? Acknowledging him. When I drive to work in the morning, I will look around outside and I'm like, God, this is beautiful. Like, you did some handiwork, right? Like the leaves. Yes, I'm feeling that. It's beautiful. When I am, you know, eating lunch even, I'm like, God, like, thank you so much for this food. Like, you hooked your girl up, right? Help it to nourish me, please. Or, you know, when I'm driving home and I'm frustrated and there's traffic, for example, God, I'm so frustrated right now, but like, I have a car and I have a job and I have a home to go to. So I thank you. Help me with my frustration. But when I say press into him, bask in him, what I mean is acknowledge his existence and spend some time with him, right? That obviously ultimately is going to be in the word of God. That's going to be in prayer, right? I have a prayer room. I'm looking that way because I'm in my office and my prayer room is in my office. I literally cleared out an entire closet, but it doesn't have to be that fancy. It can be sitting and praying. I have a beloved mama, Jay, who is a part of this ministry with me, and she sent me a prayer cloth, right? A prayer covering. And so if you don't have a whole closet, you can get a prayer cloth. You don't even have to have a prayer cloth. You can just sit and kneel and pray to God. You can be on the couch, whatever. But make sure that you're spending time with God, right? He's the vine. We are the branches. And apart from him, we can do nothing. So it is so interesting how us as humans are so quick to get all the stuff, right? The pot, the window, the fertilizer, get all the stuff that we think is going to help us flourish and grow, and forget the one thing that we need, which is the source. It's our God. And so I want to say a quick prayer for anybody who might be needing to press in during this time, who might have noticed that they have neglected some of that time with God, and maybe even notice that, hey, I am just alive, but I'm not growing in him. And there's no judgment and no condemnation. We all fall into those little pits. But I want to pray real quick for everybody. And then I will call it a day. I'll let y'all go. So Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this time that we have to spend together and fellowship with you, God. Right now, I ask that you would touch each and every one of my brothers and sisters, your sons and daughters, wherever they are, God. You know their heart and you know their needs. You know their hurts and their pains, God. So for everyone who has felt like I feel stagnant, I feel like I'm languishing, I feel like maybe I've been neglecting some of my time with you, God, I ask that you would kind of prick their spirit, God. Let them know that this word is for them, Father God. And I ask that you would give them the strength, God, to come to you and to ask you to help them with this, God. I ask that you would give them the strength that it takes to be able to cut out some of those things in our lives that might be drawing them away from you, God, so that they can make room to sit with you and to be with you, God. I ask that you would help them to see your hand and your presence in each and everything that they do in this day, God, and that you would allow the Holy Spirit and to remind them that he is always there and he is always with them and he is always taking care of them, God. I ask that you would help them to talk with you and to commune with you more, God. And to remember that you are a God who loves them with an everlasting love, God, and that you never have stagnation as part of the plan for them. They might be camped out. They might not be setting out, God, but they are not stagnant, even if they are camping, God. So whatever work that you're doing in them, whatever thing that you're creating in them, whatever thing that you're breaking off of them, God, I ask that you would give them peace during this process. I ask that you would help them to turn to you, and I ask that you would help them to see this growth taking place quickly, God, and that they would see all of the changes that you're doing in their lives, God. So I thank you, Lord. I bless your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, y'all. Take care. As always, you've got this because God's got you, and I am always here for you. I can't wait until we get to spend some time together again. So I will see you very soon.